The chaos and desperation in Afghanistan is a shame to the West. Those words coming from Germany's President Frank-Walter Steinmeier as the government works on evacuating its people and Afghan civilians. Here's the full story.
Thousands of Afghan civilians desperate to flee Taliban rule have thronged Kabul airport in the past few days, to the shame of Western nations, according to Germany's President Frank-Walter Steinmeier on Tuesday. Germany, which had the second largest military contingent in Afghanistan after the United States, said it would work with its partners in the European Union to provide aid to neighbouring countries facing an influx of Afghan civilians. The country's foreign minister, Heiko Maas, speaking ahead of an EU foreign minister's emergency meeting, said Berlin was working to get as many people as possible out of Afghanistan, among them German-Afghan dual nationals, as well as rights activists, lawyers, and people who worked with foreign forces. Kawa Spartak manages an Afghan refugee organization in Berlin and says Germany must take a leading role in helping Afghans to get out.
Particularly the German government have missed a lot of opportunities. They have missed the opportunities to evacuate people. They have missed the opportunities to inform their own population about the security in Afghanistan. They were actually more concentrated on deportations.
The UN refugee agency UNHCR, meanwhile, called for an immediate halt to forced deportations of Afghan asylum seekers. Austria, which insisted it plans to keep deporting illegal immigrants back to Afghanistan, even as the Taliban seized Kabul, has suggested setting up deportation centres in nearby countries as an alternative. A photograph showing more than 600 Afghan men, women and children crouching on the floor of a US military plane has gone viral on social media, shining a spotlight on the plight of Afghan civilians who want to flee.
The United States has completed a drawdown of personnel from its embassy in the Afghan capital of Kabul. According to the State Department, diplomatic staff remaining in Afghanistan are helping with the evacuation of other American citizens and Afghan allies. A White House official says 1,100 U.S. citizens, permanent residents, and their families have been flown out of Afghanistan so far. Evacuation flights out of Kabul resumed Monday following the chaos that was prompted by the Taliban's takeover.
Right now, Nick, we're focused on the mission at hand. And the mission at hand is precisely what I was describing to you. That is an effort to relocate, in some cases repatriate to the United States, in other cases to relocate to third countries, as many individuals as we can over as much time as we might have. Right now, we are thinking about this in terms of August 31st. It is safe and responsible for us to potentially stay longer, that is something that we may be able to look at.
Meanwhile, people fleeing the Taliban's rule in the United Kingdom arrived in the UK Tuesday. Britain planned to relocate 5,000 people as part of its Afghan relocations and assistance policy. But they also announced a new evacuation scheme that would prioritize women, girls, and minorities. The U.S. freezes roughly $10 billion in assets of Afghanistan's central bank as they try to keep the Taliban from accessing government money. Shipments of cash to the war-torn country were also stopped. Sources say the decision was made by U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen and officials at the Treasury's Office of Foreign Assets Control. DA Afghan Bank has $9.5 billion in assets, most of which are held in accounts in the United States. Meanwhile, Afghanistan's currency dropped to a record low as the acting central bank governor fled the country. The Afghani fell as much as 4.6% on Tuesday, a fourth day of decline following the Taliban's swift and chaotic takeover of the country.